I had a normal video planned for this weekend about a light-hearted topic, right? But some big shit just went down, so I guess we're going to talk about another fun topic instead. Racism! Judge Gray residing. Now listen, I'm sure everyone's seen or heard about it already, right? But really quickly, for those of you who don't know because you live in a cave or something, there's a huge news story that's blowing the fuck up recently, and I just wanted to weigh in and give you guys my opinion on it. Okay, what happened, right? These four black 18-year-olds kidnapped a white guy with some learning disabilities or something, who they fucking tied up and kept hostage, almost, and did some pretty horrible shit to him. They pretty much kind of just tortured the fucking guy. All while screaming shit like, fuck white people,
fuck white people,
and fuck Trump.
Fuck Donald Trump, nigga.
But the real stupidity comes in from what the police themselves said after they arrested the four. The fucking superintendent of the Chicago police force, Eddie Johnson, said that police were investigating if the incident was a hate crime, but said that so far, there was no indication that it was motivated by race.
Fuck white people.
Goof-ass white men.
Or by politics.
Donald Trump won, bitch.
Fuck Donald Trump, bitch.
To this bitch-ass, Donald Trump-ass, voting-ass nigga.
No indication whatsoever. What the fuck, Eddie? Did you even watch the bastard video? All it was racist and political shit. And did you not hear their racial comments, mate? And did you not hear how many times they said, fuck Trump? In the 29 minutes and 53 seconds of total stream time over the two videos, right, they mentioned Trump over 15 times. How can you say fuck Trump that many times and still think there's no political motivation? Why the fuck do you think he was saying fuck Trump so much then? Cause he thought The Apprentice sucked.
A young nigga got it bad cause I'm brown.
Okay, listen, quick update as I'm making this video, right? This shit is fucking unbelievable, man. Do you know what two representatives of the police department, including Eddie himself, said about the crimes committed in a later press conference? Well, just have a listen to what they said yourself and the tone that they said it in.
I think some of it is just stupidity.
You know, although they are adults, they're 18. They're young adults and they make stupid decisions.
I could not agree more myself. This is just some young people making some silly decisions in life, isn't it? Ha! Those crazy kids kidnapping white people and torturing them. Ha ha! Here's a lollipop, kids. Go on and run off your crazies. Jesus fucking Christ, man. They're talking about it like they were arrested for drawing dicks on the tables in maths class and writing a little graffiti that the teacher's gay. Why are they being treated like what they did was fucking nothing? Did I just miss the fucking purge or something? Why didn't I hear about that shit in the news?
They have the authority to kill a minority.
I cannot get over that wording, man.
They're young adults, and they make stupid decisions.
A stupid decision? A stupid decision, huh, mate? All right, I see now. Oh, what didn't you say, mate? A stupid decision. You mean kind of like whatever stupid decision it also was that landed this same stupid cunt in jail just 3 fucking months ago. She was arrested just 3 months ago, and she's doing shit like this already. Looks like she learned her fucking lesson, didn't it, you dickheads? Listen, this clearly isn't just a stupid decision, mate. It seems to be a fucking habit. She's been arrested before and she's doing shit like this so shortly after having been bailed out for a previous crime. They tortured the fucking guy in what was obviously a racist attack.
Fuck white people, boy.
Goof-ass white man.
You're a white nigga walking out of the street to me, boy.
And she and her friends had zero sympathy for him while they were doing it.
Beating his ass. Move his ass deserved it.
It's my friend.
This shit is hilarious.
And it seems like she's part of a gang.
We on some gang shit.
Gang
shit.
Gang shit
only. PBG, yeah.
And they seem violent as fuck.
You talking about putting them out in this misery.
This is knock your ass the fuck out right now, nigga. Instead of hurt me to kill you, nigga. Fuck you.
And let's not forget the fact that she streamed the entire thing on Facebook. So she's clearly pretty proud of what she was doing at the time. It's pretty fucking obvious that she does not see what she did as a bad thing at all. So given that, right, I don't fucking understand why these four racist idiots are being treated so well by these senior law enforcement officers.
Punk motherfucker with a badge and a gun to be beaten on.
Now seriously, I don't understand why anyone would want to defend these idiots under any fucking circumstances. But the shit part, right, people are still defending them. I cannot believe this shit. According to reports, Police are still insisting that the white 18-year-old was targeted for his special needs and not his race.
White people, what?
Goof-ass white man.
You know the white nigga walking down the street to me.
Yep, sounds like they're attacking his special needs to me. And it's not just them, right? But it's the media too. Just listen to what CNN anchor Don Lemon said regarding their crimes.
You just try to wrap your head around evil. That's what this is. It's evil. It's brutality.
I don't think it's evil. I don't think it's evil. I think these are young people, and I think they have bad home training.
Just what? What the fuck? Just bad home training? What the fuck does that even mean? Isn't this is a group of four cunts who kidnapped and tortured another man, not a dog who pissed on the carpet. Bad home training. You fucking idiot. What the fuck is going on with the world, man? Is the entire planet full of idiots now? How do you kidnap and torture an 18-year-old guy with special needs and get this much sympathy from the police and the media? Now that shit blows my mind, man. Like, serious question, right? But is it because he's a white male? Because, right, I cannot fucking imagine anyone being nearly as nice and fucking understanding towards the criminals if they were white men who kidnapped and tortured a black woman, screaming praise Trump over and over again, and saying shit like fuck black people to her. Do you think there'll be any confusion as to whether or not that was racially or politically motivated then? No, of course not. That would be a huge deal if you took this situation and did nothing but change the skin color, gender, and the political views expressed, and nothing about what was actually done, the seriousness of the crime somehow becomes a lot worse. That's fucking ridiculous, man. That's not what crime or law is about. Listen, this is a serious as fuck crime either way. Skin color, gender, or political view shouldn't change dick. Oh, seriously though, right? Are people this fucking dumb when it comes to race? Listen, the double standards when it comes to race and racism in some situations, right, is fucking unreal nowadays. Now listen, right, I might make a quick video on some of the racial double standards there are. And one in particular that I've commonly seen on TV, right, is fucking insane. Like, it's actually fucking unbelievable. But listen, right, I've talked enough. That's my views on the situation, and I need to stop fucking talking now. But in summary, right, lock the fuckers up. Thanks.
Smack his ass with the Bible. We need that.